3-year-old racing stars were in action on Saturday, and we may have seen the division leaders in the 3-year-old division for the Colts and the fillies, Thorpedo Anna winning the CCA Oaks, and an exciting finish in the Haskell Stakes with Dornoch defeating the 3-5 favorite Mindframe in a replay of the Belmont Stakes. Let's take a look at the racing recap. We've got Dornoch winning the Haskell Stakes, his second Grade 1 Stakes win in a row. Meanwhile, Thorpedo Anna continues to dominate the 3-year-old filly division. She wins the CCA Oaks. That is after the Kentucky Oaks, and also earlier this year winning the Acorn Stakes. She could try to go for the Grand Slam in the Alabama Stakes coming up. You've got an update on the Travers update. They'll be painting the canoe next month at Saratoga. And Jim Dandy up next for the 3-year-old Colts. Let's take a look at the race replays. We've got Dornoch in the Haskell Stakes. Of course, the favorite in the race was 3-5. Fierceness scratched. He is going to go to the Jim Dandy Stakes, but Dornoch, look at this. Now, early on in the race, Mindframe, the 3-5 favorite, elected to lay back. It looked like there was a lot of speed in this race, but Tuscan Sky never got involved. Mindframe laid off the pace. Timberlake was forced to the lead off the layoff. That set up a matchup going into the turn. Mindframe makes his move, takes the lead very briefly, but Dornoch at the rail. Nice ride from Louis Saez. He saved ground all the way around, and then Dornoch getting the win, outgaming Mindframe down the lane. He has got the Grade 1 Haskell, the Grade 1 Belmont Stakes, and the Grade 2 Fountain of Youth. The buyer speed figures have spoken. Dornoch gets a 103 buyer for that Haskell Stakes victory, and most likely the 3-year-old leader going into August for that 3-year-old championship. Meanwhile, let's take a look at this Belmont. The finish looked a lot the same. Dornoch was at the rail, Mindframe in the middle of the track kind of drifting out. Now, they have mentioned that Mindframe might get blinkers on for his next start, but Dornoch 2-for-2 defeating Minot in the Belmont Stakes and the Haskell Stakes. Now we go to the Spa, Saratoga, the 3-year-old leader, Thorpedo Anna. Let's watch the CCA Oaks. Starting off with the break, Thorpedo Anna breaks slow in a 4-horse field. She's last early, recovers. By that first turn, she's in second place, tracking the leaders, Leslie's Rose. Then we start to advance. You've got Thorpedo Anna cruises up on the turn, starts to take that lead, and then goes on to the authoritative victory. Thorpedo Anna, now with 3 straight Grade 1 wins, the Kentucky Oaks, the Acorn, and the CCA Oaks. Next up, maybe the Alabama, or does she point for the Cotillion at Parks at 1 1/8? We'll see what trainer Ken McPeak wants to do. Thorpedo Anna, a 95 buyer, and does she go to the Alabama next? Meanwhile, Saratoga, they're mowing the lawn at the Spa. We've got an exciting turf race, 5 horses with a chance to win, and Pounce, the 8 horse, getting up on the outside. Big day around the country for Mark Cassie. Of course, he wins some races at the Spa, Woodbine, and all around the country. Pounce, a nice 3-year-old on the turf, mowing the lawn at Saratoga. We'll see where he goes next for his continued turf races for Pounce. Meanwhile, the Jim Dandy field starting to line up for next Saturday. We're going to do a race preview when that field is announced. Sierra Leone continues to train forwardly for Chad Brown. He is going to be one of the top favorites in that race, but along with Fierceness scratching out of the Haskell, batting down back-to-back wins. He won the Ohio Derby. He's pointed for the Jim Dandy. Protective, Seize the Gray, the Preakness winner for the coach, Dwayne Lucas. He worked out 6 furlongs in 1/12 in his most recent workout, along with Gould's Gold for trainer Ken McPeak. Now, the Travers Stakes starting to come along now. We've got possibility of Dornoch, Unmatched Wisdom, the Curlin Stakes winner, and Honor Marie. Those are ones that are kind of pointing tentatively towards that race. Let's go back to Friday. Big favorite at the Spa, the Curlin Stakes, a 3-year-old Colts, a small field, but Unmatched Wisdom, who is 2-for-2 coming in. He wins this race, goes wire to wire. He's now 3-for-3 for the Banker Boys, Clarovich Stables, and Chad Brown, the trainer. So Chad Brown could have two horses in the Travers. He's got unmatched wisdom, probably going to point, and we'll see if Sierra Leone comes out of next race this week in the Jim Dandy. But unmatched wisdom now 3-for-3, wins the Curlin Stakes, defeated Corporate Power, who had won a nice little minor stakes race at Pimlico. I think a good solid barometer of that division. And unmatched wisdom brings a 3-for-3 record into the Travers Stakes possibility. Now the Whitney field starting to line up. National Treasure, big win the last time out in the Met Mile. Got Skippy Longstocking, a win earlier this year at Oaklawn Park. Cruppy, a winner at Belmont, defeated Ben Dugan that race. Bright Future, a comeback winner for Todd Pletcher. And then you've got Arthur's Ride. Looks like he is going to point. He won an allowance race at Belmont at Saratoga Week. That was a 111 buyer, one of the biggest buyer speed figures of the year. So Arthur's Ride going to point for the mile and eighth Whitney for trainer Bill Mott. But that's always a big race. They go a mile and eighth, and it's coming up in just a couple of weeks. National Treasure continues to work towards it, and I'm sure we'll see Bright Future and Arthur's Ride. It looks like the winner of the Stephen Foster Kings Barnes, he is going to point for the Jockey Club Gold Cup for trainer Todd Pletcher. So that older division starting to coming into play now. Summer Derby season continues. We've got the Jim Dandy. That'll be at Saratoga. We've got the Travers. Of course, they'll paint the new canoe at Saratoga. Then we go to the mountains, West Virginia Derby, Alabama Stakes for three-year-old fillies. We still got the Cotillion and the Pennsylvania Derby coming up. And, of course, a big prep for the Pennsylvania Derby, the Smarty Jones Stakes prep race coming up, the Whitney Stakes, and the Pacific Classic will headline some of those older division races as we have Del Mar kicking off on Saturday. So the two-year-olds starting to come into the fore. Meanwhile, I've got a tip sheet coming up for the Jim Dandy card. That's next Saturday. If you sign up once, you're good for all the days. We've got a Travers sheet, a Jim Dandy sheet, a Whitney Stakes, Breeders' Cup. If you've already signed up, you're good to go. You don't need to do anything else. It'll come out Saturday mornings. If you haven't signed up, it's free. Just kind of some analysis, couple of picks in each race, just kind of give you some thoughts, my thoughts to kind of match up with your handicapping. It's meant to supplement your handicapping. Also, I have a video out there on the five most exciting stretch finishes in recent Kentucky Derby history. Some exciting stretch runs. You can watch that up on the channel now as we get into Del Mar and Saratoga season. Of course, the big news coming out, Bob Baffert, the suspension rescinded by Churchill Downs, and Bob Baffert now going to be eligible for the 2025 Kentucky Derby. We'll talk more about that in the weeks ahead as we get the road to the 2025 Kentucky Derby. That starts really in September. That kicks off with the Iroquois Stakes at Churchill Downs. So lots of racing action still to come. Three-year-old scene starting to get ready. Is Dornoch the best three-year-old, the three-year-old division leader as we go into the Jim Dandy and up to the Travers? Leave a comment on the racing on Saturday. Dornoch, Thorpedo, Anna, what did you think of some of the stakes races at Monmouth here on the channel? Remember, D. Wayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.